गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर निपुण लांबा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पैलिएटिव मेडिसिन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, इंटरवेंशंस फॉर पेन इन पैलिएटिव केयर इन कैंसर पेशेंट्स. पेन इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट बिकॉज इट अफेक्ट्स द कैंसर पेशेंट्स इन अ वेरी सिवियर वे. दिस इमेज वेरी मच समराइजेज व्हाट इज पैलिएटिव केयर. ए फिजिशियन होल्डिंग हैंड ऑफ हिज पेशेंट एट द एंड ऑफ लाइफ. So this image indicates what palliative care is. What is the WHO definition of palliative care? Palliative care is an approach that improves the quality of life of patients and their families which are facing the problems associated with life-threatening illnesses. Through prevention and relief of suffering by means of early assessment and treatment of pain and other problems which may be physical, psychosocial, spiritual. A good quality palliative care is defined as the care which I would be happy to be given to a member of my own family or myself when he or she was dying or when my time comes. This is WHO step ladder which is indicating the treatment of pain in cancer patients. In step 1 there is non-opioids and adjuvants we are using for management of pain. If pain is persistent or increasing, then we use opioids for mild to moderate pain with non-opioids and adjuvants. If the pain is still persistent or increasing, then we use opioids for moderate to severe pain along with non-opioids and adjuvants. We are using lidocaine infusion for chronic pain. Lidocaine is a commonly used local anesthetic. We are using it intravenously in management of neuropathic pain in cancer patients. What is the advantage of lidocaine infusion? It binds the voltage-gated central channels. So it treats central sensitization in peripheral neuropathy, erythromyalgia and visceral hypersensitivity. There are also risks like tingling, drowsiness, but there are no long-term side effects with lidocaine infusion. It provides long-term therapeutic effects with short-term profound pain reduction. It is a one-day outpatient infusion in hospital. It can also be done round the clock. Lidocaine infusion is given as a part, not as a treatment. It is a part of complete pain plan that includes physical therapy, psychological therapy and other non-opioid pain medications. This is an interventional procedure, celiac plexus block, which we have done in a patient of cancer, carcinoma of pancreas, having severe abdominal pain. As you are seeing in this image, this is the lumbar vertebral column, and at the level of T12 and L1, we have performed celiac plexus block. We are seeing the dye spread in front of the vertebral bodies. And after that, we have given absolute alcohol to perform chemical neurolysis of celiac plexus. Same image. We are also performing spinopalatine ganglion block in management of head and neck facial pain in head and neck cancer patients. What we are doing in it, we are using 3.5-inch cotton tip applicator soaked in local anesthetic, and applicator is advanced along the superior border of middle turbinate of each nostril until tip comes in contact with mucosa overlying the spinopalatine ganglion. Spinopalatine ganglion, we are using transnasal approach. 3 ml of 2% viscous lidocaine is used in a 5 ml syringe. Cotton applicators are soaked in local anesthetic and is advanced along the superior border of middle turbinate. Then 1 ml of local anesthetic is instilled over cotton tip applicator also. The applicator allows the local anesthetic to remain in contact with mucosa. The applicators are removed after 20 minutes. This is an image in which we are performing trigeminal nerve block, mandibular or maxillary or even ophthalmic division of trigeminal nerve we are performing in head and neck cancer patients. This is a needle. This is the needle entry point. We are hitting the lateral pterygoid plate, and as we can see that V3 is the mandibular nerve which is passing. So we target it and we block it either through steroid and local anesthetic, or we perform complete chemical neurolysis by using 100% absolute alcohol. In it, the patient is placed in supine position with cervical spine in neutral position. The coronoid approach is identified by opening and closing the mouth. A 2 ml 100% alcohol is taken in a 5 ml syringe. After the skin overlying the coronoid notch has been prepared with antiseptic solution, 22 gauge 3.5 inch stellated needle is inserted just below the zygomatic arch. directly into the middle of coronoid notch. Needle is advanced 1.5 to 2 inches in a plane perpendicular to skull until lateral pterygoid plate is encountered. After blockage, the pain score rapidly falls after this procedure. Why is palliative care important? Because it controls pain as well as perform the symptom management and better quality of life while still continuing the curative measures. Palliative care is a holistic care which aims not only at pain control but also taking emotional and social needs of the patient, spiritual and practical concerns. It offers patient and family members more satisfaction in treatment and care they receive. It ensures better communication between patient, caregivers and healthcare providers. Various interventional pain relief measures techniques have been used with WHO stepladder to provide better pain relief. In the end, I will say that palliative care is a care beyond cure. Never say there is nothing we can do, but say there is always something we can do. Thank you.